Hi, my name is Jasmine. In this video, I am going to explain you how you can set up your organization in T3. You can find one pre-configured organization in the instance delivered. You can change the name of the entity or organization as needed. It is important to define all these details, but it is not mandatory. So update registration number, currency, country, city, etc. at your convenience. We can't select headed by here because we do not have employees created in this organization yet. You have the flexibility to decide how you want employment IDs to be generated or created manually. There are four options that includes random code 4-digit generated by system. Next is 6-digit random code. You can also generate IDs in the sequential order or manually enter employment IDs. You can also set validation rules in case of manual. If you want to accept employment ID in uppercase or lowercase, or set a maximum length of the ID entered manually. These IDs needs to be unique in all the scenarios. If you decide to go with sequential employment ID generation option, then you have the flexibility to define where you wish to start from and also add prefix if needed. It is important to note that you cannot change these preferences even when a single employee is created in the system. In the given example, your next employment ID will be generated as NVC5401 and then it will continue in the sequential order. The next important step is to define if you deploy resources in the projects. This helps system to understand if your resources work with your clients on billable assignments. System changes some user interfaces according to this preference. T3 is mostly delivered without any logo, but you can either change the existing logo or add a new logo by pressing Choose File button. This will let you browse the files available on your local computer so you can pick and choose. You can also change the logo at any time in the future. Now let's move to the next stage where you can set up your operating units. You can find a pre-configured operating unit with the name Head Office. You can either change the name or add a new operating unit as per your needs. Here I am adding one operating unit that is Projects Division. Your HR operation is based on the operating units, so if you are operating from a central location, then you do not need to create multiple operating units. However, if your HR operation is decentralized, then you need to create multiple operating units and grant access to local HR accordingly. You can select the operating unit type from the list and define the operating country and city as applicable. Even when you have one operating unit, you can still have multiple office locations or work locations. One work location can also be assigned to two different operating units if needed. It is important to link single or multiple work locations to the operating unit so that the local HR associated with the operating unit can access employees of these work locations. If you do not link any work location to the operating unit, then the HR administrator associated with that operating unit will neither be able to onboard any new employee in the work location nor be able to view any employee. Let's add one work location in the newly created operating unit. We find two work locations to choose from. Work locations can be added from the drop-down listing setup application. It is mandatory to define operating unit and work location while adding employees. Employee data security evolves around the structure that you build in this stage. You can also modify this structure at any time in the future. That's all we have in this video. Thanks for attending this session.